Good morning, everyone. We'll get started. Thank you for joining us.
All right, folks, get started.
Good morning. We are joined by many members of the caucus in the Senate and the House. We're also joined by Treasurer Dave Young for today's announcement. We're going to hear from, in addition to Treasurer Young, Speaker Garnett, Majority Leader Moreno. As you know, a big focus for the Democrats in this year's legislative session and for us is saving people money. And there's a number of real policies that we can point to that have done just that, whether it's reinsurance, which has reduced the rate for individuals who buy their own health care insurance by over 20%. We slashed the price of state park passes by 70%. Free full-day kindergarten saves families about $500 per month already in place. And later today, we'll be signing the bill for universal preschool. And in addition to the benefit for the kids, that also saves families an average of $4,300 per year. We've already cut property taxes for 2 years, made it so tens of thousands of small businesses don't have to even file the business personal property tax. And we're working towards infusing $600 million in the Unemployment Insurance Trust Fund to prevent payroll tax increases. We're also providing relief on driver's license fees, reducing vehicle registration fees, and much, much, much more. I really wasn't kidding when I performed Paul Simon's hit single back in January, that we want to find 50 ways to save people money. And today, we're taking another big step to save people money. The proposal that will soon be introduced, the Colorado dividend for every hardworking Colorado taxpayer, will give refunds of $400 per person, $800 per joint filer this summer, late August, early September. That's right, this summer, every Colorado taxpayer will get $400, joint filers, $800. We know that this last year has been difficult. Rising prices, gas at $4 a gallon, groceries costing more. And rather than sit on this money, we know that $400 will help people now. And this is because of our strong economy that we have these resources. We have the fifth strongest economic rebound in the country. We've recovered more than 100% of the jobs that were lost during the pandemic. But we also know that despite there being good jobs out there, the rising costs are a real challenge for Colorado families. And that's why we're working to get this relief out as soon as possible. Instead of government sitting on the money, we want to make sure we get it back to people and empower Coloradans to invest this Colorado dividend in their own families, in their communities, in their everyday needs, or in saving for retirement or for school. This is because of our economic success as a state, this Colorado dividend will benefit every hardworking Colorado taxpayer. And I want to thank President Fenberg, Speaker Garnett, Majority Leader Escar Majority Leader Moreno for their leadership on this important opportunity to truly help Coloradans get by. Now I'm happy to introduce the Treasurer for the State of Colorado, Treasurer Dave Young.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Dave Young. I'm the Colorado State Treasurer. A strong recovery in Colorado's economy means that the state will have the financial limits set by the Colorado Taxpayer Bill of Rights, and we've hit those limits or will soon. However, I know that not everyone has been feeling this recovery. Many hardworking families are needing relief now, and so the Colorado Department of Treasury will ensure that there is sufficient cash flow to successfully issue TABOR refunds. We will do this by closely following our investment policy, which stresses safety, liquidity, and yield in that order of priority as key goals for all of the taxpayer funds entrusted to us. So it's a proud day for us. We are happy to support this effort by legislative leadership and the governor, and thank them for their work to make this happen.
No worries, Dave, no worries, no worries, no worries. Good morning, everyone. I'm excited to be here today with the governor, with the treasurer, with members of the Senate and House caucuses. Coloradans should be very, very proud that our state is experiencing one of the fastest economic recoveries in the nation. Our resilience as a state and the steps we've taken to position Colorado to thrive are boosting our economy and boosting our recovery. We've taken historic action to stimulate our economy and put money back in the pockets of hardworking Coloradans and save families and small businesses money. In recent years, we've been focusing on helping save Coloradans money. We've saved families money on health care and prescription drugs. We've boosted the incomes of working Coloradans by thousands of dollars by increasing the earned income tax credit and the child tax credit. And we've saved seniors money by making their Social Security benefits tax deductible. On the opening day of this legislative session, I said saving Coloradans money and making our state more affordable would be our top priority. We are looking at every way we can to save people money and boost their incomes and reduce costs. This announcement today is a very big deal. We're delivering once again on our promise to address the rising cost of living in our state and make Colorado more affordable. These checks will immediately help people afford the rising cost of gas, groceries, rent, mortgages, childcare, and so many other items and services that are costing more. Sending out these $400 and $800 checks now will help those Coloradans make sure that they have the resources during the highest parts of the inflationary pressures that they're feeling to help afford those needs. This is Coloradans' money. This is their money, and we're making sure that we make government efficient and getting those dollars back to them as quickly as possible. I'm excited to be here today, and I'm excited to announce Senate Majority Leader Dominic Moreno.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. This morning, I'm proud to join Governor Polis and my colleagues in the House and Senate to unveil a key component of our plan to put money in the back in the pockets of Coloradans. As a recovering member of the Joint Budget Committee, I've spent much of my career in the General Assembly finding ways to stretch every dollar as far as possible in our state budget. And Coloradans have been doing the same. And so that's why today we announce our plan to help make that a bit easier, to help send money back to Coloradans, $400 for a single filer, $800 for a joint filer. That is a month's worth of groceries for the average family in Colorado. That is the kind of relief that we need to be providing to Coloradans right now in wake of rising inflation that we are seeing across the country and right here in our state. Since day one of this session, we've prioritized easing the burden on hardworking Coloradans, whether that's through lowering the cost of professional license fees to making childcare more affordable or housing more affordable. We're doing all we can to relieve the pressures and the burdens that are being experienced by the majority of Coloradans today. This is the type of tax relief, this is the type of relief in general that Coloradans expect that their state government deliver on. And so by advancing these payments, by making sure these dollars get into the pockets of people as soon as possible, we can help combat that rising inflation and help folks when they need it the most, which is absolutely right now. Back to you, Governor Polis.
And really one of the reasons this press conference is so short is it's a very simple policy. Check your mailbox in late August, early September, and if you're a Colorado resident, pay taxes, you'll get $400 back, $800 for joint filers. It's that simple.